We've had a batch of activity data released today from China, including inflation, producer prices, industrial output, retail sales, and weaker than expected trade data yesterday. Joining me now to discuss some of these figures is Chen Xingdong, Chief China Economist at BNP Paribas Securities Asia. Nice to speak to you, Chen. So for you, were there any particular disappointing figures that came out when compared to previous expectations?
Today's number is very surprising. We could put it a shocking number to large extent, because the industrial output number is so low to 9.3%. Although this number is still substantially higher to many, many countries in this world, but it's opposite very much sharp comparison to more than 12% growth expectations by the market consensus and ours as well. It seems has gone to a conflicting with other economic indicators, particular PMI. PMI actually has kept improving both for official and HSBC PMI. But industrial output is definitely coming to this low. Apparently the growth momentum is substantially weakened from what the market expected.
In terms of China's inflation, do you think the economy is beginning to stabilize somewhat?
No, inflation is nothing unusual. It's very much in line with our expectation. We expect about 3.4% exactly coming out with 3.4% in April. That is nothing unusual. Apart from we see it is still staying to this level, at the moment, mainly inflation is contributed by food. Agriculture production has been under somehow pressure. We don't see this is going to be go away anytime soon, but it would not worry inflation compared to the government's set target 4%. So it will be below 4%. But I think a lot of economic indicator suggesting for the macro, the real economy in China is far from being stabilized.
Despite the slowdown, China's major economic indicators are still at relatively healthy levels. A soft rather than a hard landing seems to be in place, is it not?
I don't use a hard landing term. I use China is facing economic growth substantial slowing down risk. Well, China set its GDP growth target at 7.5% for the year 2012. We still do not worry about this one, but in reality, is actually what the market expects China growth should retain more than 8%. Some people say even higher than 8%. Then we will see there is a growth gap. Apparently, the current economic growth require the Chinese government the policy more to ease rather than to stay continuously low.
The Chinese government seems to be quite proactive in terms of both fiscal and monetary policy. Do you think the government's easing policies have begun to take effect?
Today, from our monitors and observations, the Chinese government has apparently become more aggressive in easing the policy. But the question now is not only from the policy easing part, but it should also create more demands. And it's critical, important to note that external demands becoming weakening rather than stronger. And particularly European side is becoming so uncertain. China's export to EU is now suffering from negative growth rather than from a positive and improved growth like to US market. So overall, external demands are so weak. Therefore, China needed to create additional domestic demand in order to supplement what it is external demand losing or weakening. So for this part, it's really bringing a major challenges facing China.
As we know, one of the most significant issues affecting China's short-term sustainable growth is housing. What are your views on the current housing market and Beijing's strict property market rules?
Housing price control policy now is coming to a critical period. After more or less 2 years implementation of housing price control, I would say the housing price control policy has been effective. However, the housing price control policy from political point of view is very difficult to be removed anytime soon. But this policy has put the housing developers and local governments in a very difficult and increasing difficult position. Now, housing sector is becoming a big constraint to the current economic growth momentum. I would expect the government may have to make somehow changes, trying to make a structural easing and trying to narrow down the housing price control policy to be a specific portion of housing, such as high-end housing, and the policy control will be only on speculative and investment demand. They should allow the real demand, living-oriented housing demands to be continued.
Thank you, Chen, for sharing your outlook on the Chinese economy. Now, for more interviews like this one, stay tuned to Dukas Copy TV. But for the moment, goodbye.